Hi everyone. So now the next topic is the properties of division. This is for exercise 2.5. Till now we have done the properties of addition, subtraction and multiplication. Now the last one is the properties of division. Now what are the properties in this? Let's see. First is the closure property. Closure property always says is that when we are going to take any two whole numbers and when we are going to apply any operation between those two numbers, whether it is of plus, minus, multiply or divide, it has to be a whole number. But in the case of division, what they are saying is it is not always a whole number. If I am going to take any two numbers, now see, whole numbers, you all know the numbers which are going to start from 0 and then they are going to last up to infinity. Okay, so now let me take any two numbers. For example, in this I have taken A as 12 and B I have taken 24. Now I know that these two are whole numbers. A is 12, B is 24. Okay, now I have to divide these two. Let me divide A divided by 5. That means I am going to write as 12 by 24. This is the only meaning of this, because A is 12 and B is 24. Now these two are going on the table of 12. So I can cancel them on 12. 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24. So this means it is coming 1 upon 2. But is this fraction a whole number? No, this is not a whole number. Since it is not a whole number, so that means my division, my closure property in the case of division does not satisfy every time. Why I am saying every time? Let us take one more. I can say that I am taking A as 6 and B as 3. Okay. Now I have to divide it. Let me divide it. 6 upon 3, because the value of A is 6 and the value of B is 3. 3 ones are, 3 twos are. So my answer is 2. But 2 is a whole number. Okay. So that means, now this is a whole number, so that means the closure property is not always satisfying in the case of division. Okay, sometimes it is satisfying and sometimes it is not satisfying. It is not satisfying only in the cases when my denominators are larger. Okay, so now this I have done example 1 and 2 for the closure property. I hope it is clear to you. Now let's move to the second one. If A is a whole number, then A divided by 0 is not defined. Okay, now this B and C, I am going to explain you together what they are saying. This is the property basically of 0 in the case of division. Now first is, if I am going to take any whole number, okay, let us take A as 6, any whole number, and I have taken B as 0, a whole number, okay, and I have to divide A divided by B. I have to write like this. Then instead of A I am writing 6 and instead of B I am writing 0. This case is not possible. It is not defined. 0 can never come in the denominator. It is never defined. Second case, if I am going to take A and 0 and B as 6, that means what I am going to do here is 0 upon 6. In the numerator 0 can come and the answer will be 0, because if I am going to divide 0 by any number, my answer will come 0. And but here, if I'm going to divide any number with 0, answer is not defined. So please make sure that these two are the basic things which is saying that in the denominator 0 will never come. You can never divide any number by 0 because it will be not defined, and 0 can be divided by any number, it will give me answer 0. So these two are the properties of 0. Okay, so what is the if I am going to summarize these two things, it is only saying that 0 will never come in the denominator, it will give me the answer not defined. Okay, now let's move to the D part. If A is a whole number, then if A is divided by 1, the answer will be same. Obviously, if I am going to divide 5 by 1, if I am going to divide 5 by 1, this means 5 by 1, what is the answer? 5. If I am going to divide any number with 1, it will give me the same number. If I am going to divide 12 by 1, it will give me the same number. So any number when divided by 1 will give me the same number. Now our E property is division algorithm. In division algorithm, before starting, let me firstly remind you the terms which are used in the division algorithm. See, when we are dividing any number, the number which comes here is the dividend. The dividend which is divided by a certain number here when the number which is divided by a number, this is called as the divisor, by what we are dividing. So this is the divisor. Here whatever comes the answer is the quotient, and after solving everything our here comes is the remainder, right? So the number which is in the middle is the dividend. The number by which we are dividing the dividend is the divisor. The answer which we are getting here is the quotient, and in the last whatever we are getting, that is called as the remainder. So basically this you must all have done earlier also. Now what division algorithm says? Division algorithm says that whatever dividend is there, if I have to find the dividend, that means the main number, if I have to find, how I'm going to get it? I am going to multiply divisor and quotient. I will be multiplying divisor and the quotient, and whatever remainder is left, this remainder is left, I am going to add the remainder in that. So this is the division algorithm. Okay, basically we are writing as, instead of dividend we are taking A, divisor B plus Q, sorry, into Q, because this is this, and remainder is R. So this is the notation which you don't have to use, you just have to learn this one. This is the formula for the division algorithm, right? So division algorithm is dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, so now let's move to example 10. What example 10 is saying is, find the number which when divided by 43. Okay, so now what example 10 is saying, you have to find a number. Okay, the number which when divided by 43. Now they are saying we have to find this number when this number is divided by 43. This gives me 3 as quotient, that means here 3 will come, and when I am going to solve everything, my remainder will be 6. So this is given to me, that means whatever is given to me, what I have to find here, dividend I have to find, divisor is given to me 43, quotient is given to me 3, and remainder is given to me 6. Now you have to find the dividend. And what is the formula for division algorithm? Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now what is the divisor? 43. What is the quotient? 3. What is the remainder? 6. Now let us multiply. Firstly, you are going to multiply it. What you will get? 129 plus 6. And when you are going to add it, you will get 135. So that means the answer here will come 135. Okay. Now we are going to start with exercise 2.5. In 2.5, first question is fill in the blanks, that you have to complete the following statements. So first part is, dividend is equals to dash into quotient plus remainder. So this is the formula of the division algorithm. What will come here? Dividend is also there, quotient is also there, remainder is also there. What is left here? Divisor. So divisor will come here. B part, if I am going to divide 0 by any number, what will be my answer? 0. We have done it already, that if 0 is divided by any number, my answer will be 0. But if any number, for example 15, is divided by 0, my answer will be not defined, right? So if I am going to divide number 0 with any number, I will get the answer 0. Now what will come here? If I am going to divide this number by 76, and my answer will be 0, again it will be 0. If I am going to divide 0 by any number, it will give me the answer 0. Next, 31 should be divided by what so that my answer is 31? That means my same answer should be there. If 31 is there, the answer should also be 31. So I am going to divide here 31 by 1. So this will be 31 divided by 1 will give me 31. Now the next is E part, dash should be divided by 1 so that my answer should be 62. So again the same thing, when I am going to divide any number with 1 and it is giving me the same number, right? So that means if the answer is 62, my here also it will come 62. So 62 when divided by 1 will give me the same answer. It was very easy, it was based on the properties we have discussed of the division. Now the second question is, divide the following and verify your answer by the corresponding multiplication. Now what you have to do in this is, you have to divide firstly. in the first question, you have to do what is, you are going to divide 14475 by 15. Simply the way you are dividing, the way earlier you are dividing it, you have to do it the way you are doing it in the lower classes. 15 when divide, I'm going to do it, I will be getting the quotient as 965. Okay, this was the dividend, this is the divisor, this is the quotient. Now how I'm going to verify it? Verify means when I'm going to multiply my divisor with the quotient 15 and 965, when I'm going to multiply together, see I have multiplied here, my answer should be equal to the dividend, which is in the middle of this divide sign. 14475 14475, since my dividend is coming same, so that means my answer, that means my quotient is correct, that means 965 is my correct answer. Okay, so that's how you are going to verify. Let's do the next part. Let me explain you the C part. I'll be doing it C part for you. The question is 448945, you have to divide it by 707. So firstly, let us divide it by 707. Now 707, 6 is 4242. This will come 2474. Okay, then it will go on 3. It will be 2121. Simply I am dividing it. Then it will be 353, and from the up I am taking out 5. Now this will go on 5 on the table of 707. It will be 3535. Answer came right. So that means my question here is 635. Now what I have to do is I have to verify, and to verify what I'm going to do here is this 707 I am going to multiply with 635. For the verification, divisor will be multiplied by quotient. So 707 I will multiply by 635. Okay, so when I'm going to multiply it, look here, when I'm going to multiply 707 and 635, I am getting 448945, which is same as my dividend. See, if my answer is coming same as the dividend, that means my answer 635 is correct. Okay, so likewise you can do D part also. Firstly you are going to divide it by 68, and then you are going to verify. How you are going to verify? 68 you are going to multiply by 444. See how we have done here, and this 30192 is same as the dividend, and when these two answers are coming same, that means my answer is verified. Okay, similarly you can do E part also and F part also. In this also, again, firstly you are going to divide 10989 by 111. You should know how to divide, you should know. Okay, so 111 you are going to, firstly it will go on the table of 9999. Okay, and then again 999 is going on the table of 111 on 9. So my answer came 99. So if you have to check whether your 99 answer is coming correct or not, how you are going to do? You are going to multiply 111 with 99. So 111 will be multiplied by 99, and my answer came 10989, right? And this is equals to what? Dividend. So answer is correct. Similarly you can do the F part. So try to do this exercise, question 1 and question 2, in the notebooks. Okay, thank you.